Economic development, environmental sustainability, and community engagement doesn't just happen. It's a team effort. Public-private partnerships create opportunities to enhance a community and support economic growth.
So we are super excited to have GOAL as a part of our community. This is a private-public partnership, and so we partnered with GOAL and we took a soccer field that was really just two grass fields, and we were able to revitalize it into a soccer complex that will benefit the community.
In 2017, GOAL Soccer Centers began construction through a public-private partnership to revitalize two existing city-owned soccer fields. With a lease of this underutilized land asset from the city, GOAL Soccer Center invested approximately $4 million of site improvements to provide a unique soccer experience for the region. GOAL operates 46 soccer clubs in the United Kingdom. The Rancho Cucamonga Center is the first GOAL soccer club in the Inland Empire and the third in the United States.
We actually moved out to the States in 2010, where we built the first one in Southgate. Since then, we've opened another one in Pomona in earlier this year in 2017. And we've recently announced a joint venture with City Football Group, who owns Manchester City. And so we're excited that our first venue with City Football Group will be here in Rancho Cucamonga.
There are environmental benefits following the city's Sustainable Community Action Plan. This state-of-the-art facility with LED lights throughout the facility and high-quality artificial turf. The soccer facility is anticipated to reduce the city's consumption of electricity and water usage by an estimated 5.7 million gallons per year. The city's Sustainable Community Action Plan supports the Healthy RC Program philosophy of integrating healthy mind, body, and earth while increasing revenue resources, creating new jobs, fostering tourism, and expanding recreational opportunities. Our partnership provides for dedicated field time to expand the city's community services recreational programs, including the city's Incredibles program, which provides opportunities for residents with developmental, learning, and physical disabilities. Located at the Epicenter Sports Complex with our Lone Mart Field Stadium and RC Sports Center opening summer of 2018, these three venues create a dynamic sports hub for the community and Inland Empire that further broadens the appeal of Rancho Cucamonga being the place to live, work, and play.
I'm standing in front of a very exciting project in Rancho Cucamonga. Most of our residents will know this building as a former JCPenney furniture outlet store.
The Haven City Market project involves the repurposing of an outdated retail building into a modern, rustic industrial building that will house a gourmet food hall with an outdoor garden area. Haven City will feature a boutique grocery concept, approximately 25 to 30 restaurants, specialty retail shops, and a 20,000 square foot outdoor park and garden. The project will be the first of its kind in the city, drawing millennials, foodies, and families alike to its mecca of featured local makers and artisans.
And a lot of credit needs to go to the developers for taking a risk and a challenge, and to the city for thinking outside the box and really repurposing a building that was more in our industrial area and commercial office to be repurposed into a more of a retail location, creating more of a sense of community. So between the developer and the city, this plan and this vision really came together, knowing that it just doesn't happen without the partnerships between the business community as well as the city. This concept is similar to other locations in Southern California, but will be unique to Rancho Cucamonga. In fact, it might even be the first of its kind in the Inland Empire. The project will bring an interesting, eclectic mix of tenants to our city. While the lineup has not been announced just yet, the owners of the project and the listing agent are really telling us we're going to receive quite an interesting mix of tenants. For example, flavors of the Middle East, a rice pudding bar, sushi, a barbecue place, an ale house.
These boutique concepts provide for memorable experiences and creates a sense of place within the community.
And now with the development of this project, it will create more opportunities for the nearby tenants and bring in more pedestrians into the shopping center.
The project began its remodel in late 2017 and is expected to be complete by late summer 2018.
Dramatic changes in our environment, quality of construction, and type of emergencies and risks require first responders around the globe to learn new techniques and continue high-level training within the department. City leadership has been aware of this need for training on a regional level and had plans to create a facility to support our first responders as early as 1989, when the original Jersey Fire Station Master Plan was developed. As you can see, it didn't just happen. The design and construction costs were set aside through decades of planning and budgeting and are fully funded from fire district capital reserves, which are strictly allocated for use on capital projects such as facilities. Rancho Cucamonga's Fire District Regional All-Risk Training Center will maximize the skills and capabilities of our public safety organizations, as well as public safety partners and teams of trained citizen volunteers.
One of the most important things is also with our police and our sheriff's department. There are things that we can provide in this facility that they just don't get. You have the ability to actually fire projectiles within this facility without doing damage to the building at all. It gives them, the sheriff and police partners, an opportunity to be able to work more in a real world type of a scenario in which they can do it not only on the residential house and clearing a house, but they could also do it in an apartment type of a setting in different style of apartments.
This training center will provide public safety personnel with realistic, adaptable, and reusable training facilities. The buildings that have been constructed can simulate many different types of facilities like hotels, residential apartments, senior living, warehouses, strip mall centers, and cell towers. The facility has environmentally conscious features like solar, drought-resistant landscaping, and water reclamation, as well as an innovative smoke filtration system. Although this training center is primarily for the use of first responders in the city and the region, it will also serve external partners. The facility will be available to private companies and the Hollywood film industry to be used as an off-location set to simulate building fires. Through a well-executed marketing plan, the city will be able to use this facility not only to improve public safety in the region, but also as an economic driver.
Our goal is to make this training facility a completely financial, self-sustaining facility.
Public safety and community education activities such as CERT, Fire Prevention Week Open House, and Junior Firefighter Camp can be held at the training center in public meeting rooms that have capabilities for multimedia, video, and teleconferencing. This well-planned facility will be a cornerstone for first responder training, as well as future public safety professionals and community members committed to making our community safer. The city of Rancho Cucamonga has made concerted efforts to become a more sustainable community and is committed to attracting new, innovative, green technology companies and careers to the city. One such company is XT Green. Using a patented extra clean technology, XT Green will process residential and industrial carpet into high-quality nylon and polypropylene pellets to be used as replacement for virgin carpet material. Along with producing these pellets, the process also recovers calcium carbonate from the recycled material, which will then be sold as a product. Using this technology, XT Green can repurpose 95% of the material it processes. XT Green will have the capabilities to process commercial broadloom carpet, which is a highly desirable product for manufacturers, as it creates LEED credits and is often desired by commercial clients buying flooring. During phase one, XT Green will have the annual capacity to process 40 million pounds of nylon PCC, create over 100 skilled green jobs, divert 100 million pounds from landfills annually, save 13.2 million gallons of oil per year, and
the greenhouse gas benefits will be the equivalent of planting 2.5 million trees and the carbon that's sequestered from those trees over 10 years.
XT Green has been recognized as an advanced manufacturer by the state of California due to its technical advances and was a recipient of a CARE infrastructure grant. Locating their new facility in the city of Rancho Cucamonga was a natural fit. Over 50% of used carpet in California is generated in Southern California, and the access to transport, rail lines, and quality housing was important. The city's pro-green energy initiatives and the effort made by the helpful staff made Rancho Cucamonga the easy choice. The 125,000 square foot facility in Rancho Cucamonga is slated to open in the spring of 2018.